Okay, so today is Wednesday, and if you want to, you want to sit there, do you want to sit in a, in one of the chairs? Okay, all right, good. Well, if you need to, in order to be able to get the legs moving, feel free to, you know, pick a chair. So wherever you are, this is a class about the joints and glands practices, and this is about increasing our awareness of our joints and glands and our physical body and coming into the sense of awareness of the connection between the subtle and the gross aspect of the body. So I'm going to say hello to all my subscribers online and welcome you as well. And this class then has the Sanskrit name of Stula or Stula means the large or outward gross body. And body is Sharira, and then awareness. The word awareness in Sanskrit, we use the word prajna. So we say stula, sharira, prajna. And we begin with the oft-repeated instruction from Swami Rama, the living embodiment of the Himalayan yoga tradition known as the Parampara. To sit tall with the head and the neck and the trunk as straight as possible without exceeding your capacity in a normal, natural fashion. Letting the energy that's in your breath help to expand in your body as light, light energy. And this is the awareness we're speaking of. When we use the word prajna, it's literally the enlightenment. It's the moment when you become conscious of your body, you become conscious of the energy and the breath and the connection between those. And you feel it in your physical body from top to toe as you sit and let the breath move the body, breathing through the nose, breathing naturally, breathing normally. Feeling where your feet rest on the floor, where your sit bones sit on the chair, and the arrangement of your body in space, vertical in the gravitational field. This is Stula Sharira Prajna. And I always chant the invocation at the beginning of class to the original source of all awareness, the golden womb, as it's referred to in the ancient texts, the Hirana Garbha. Param, param. Shanti. Shanti. And continuing to feel the light that is in the breath as it moves the physical body naturally and normally. We continue in this meditative fashion to let the breath move the body, but with a set of movements called the joints and glands exercises, starting with the head and neck. So you may let your arms dangle beside you. Your eyes can be open or closed. And exercise number one for the head and neck is the folding forward. So as your breath exhales, let your chin come down towards your chest and let your neck relax, let your whole spine roll in. And as you inhale, let the breath lengthen your spine, lift your abdomen, your heart region, your neck, and maybe even your face and chin, shoulder blades on the back, exhaling. The exhalation is what's moving you into this ball, this shape, like one of those small little bugs we used to call pill bugs. And then as you inhale and your body rolls and unfurls itself, lengthens, your chin comes up, face comes up, shoulders on the back. And another time, a third time, perhaps as you're exhaling, your body is moving with the breath. It's not so much that you're moving your body, you're letting the breath move it. So as you inhale, it's rolling you up, just like a big rolling pin along your spine. And this time, exhaling, come down to your neutral position, sitting tall, and immediately move into exercise number two. As you exhale, your right ear folds over towards your left shoulder. Maybe your spine makes a gentle curve. As you inhale, again, your spine straightens and you sit up tall. And the exhalation, the left ear comes down towards the left shoulder. Maybe the spine makes a gentle C curve. Be careful you don't fall out of your chair. As you inhale, you come back up. And again, you go down to the right. As you exhale, your spine curves. You can draw your shoulder blade onto your back a little. Your inhalation comes up. Exhaling, go down to the other side, to the left with the left ear and the left shoulder. Maybe take your right shoulder blade a little onto your back. Let your head relax. The inhalation comes up. And one last time, the right ear descends towards the right shoulder as you exhale. And your inhalation brings you up with your breath. So you're moving in the speed of your breath. That's why it takes a little longer to do the movements, because your breath is nice and smooth and long. Exhaling, you fold over. Inhaling, you come up and remain in your vertical position, relaxed and exploring the breath, feeling the breath. We call this awareness prajna, or the experience really of the breath in the body as light. And we continue to breathe for a moment, breathing naturally, before we move into exercise number three for the head and the neck. This time, when you exhale, your head will rotate towards your right shoulder. So your right chin comes over towards your right shoulder. And as you inhale, your head comes with the inhalation, comes to face front. Face is relaxed, forehead is relaxed. Your exhalation takes you over towards the left chin. The inhalation unwinds you, brings you back to face forward. Again, your exhalation takes you over towards the right shoulder, over towards that side, and it rotates. exhalation takes you over towards the other side. Inhalation brings you back to center. And then a third time, the exhalation takes you over towards your right shoulder or whichever side you're on. Your inhalation brings you back to center. And finally, your exhalation takes you again over towards the opposite side for to complete each set. And the inhalation brings you slowly and smoothly back to center. Okay, at this point, rest your hands on your thighs if they've been dangling. And good morning, good to see you. Good to see you. And we're continuing with our joints and glands practices for Wednesday. And we're using the Sanskrit words stula, which means the gross or physical body. Sharira means body, so stula sharira means the physical body. And prajna is the Sanskrit word for awareness. So it's a way of speaking about, in a very particular way, about the awareness of your physical body. And you could just say awareness, but we really want to know that we're being conscious about what we're doing. Okay, so let us do the exercise number 4 for the head and the neck series. And this time, this is the turtling motion. So as you inhale, your face comes right out towards me, your neck extends, like you're drawing your head forward by sucking the air in your nostrils, and then you exhale the air and your skull, back of your skull moves towards the wall behind you, your chin comes in. Again, as you inhale, you sip the air through your nostrils and it's like two strings or ropes sort of pulling your face forward. And then you exhale those streams of the breath and the breath is taking your skull back towards the wall behind you. Just like a turtle, and you do that a third time, inhaling the breath, and exhaling, and taking the skull back. Very nice, very therapeutic for the head and the neck. And finally, inhaling, coming back to your normal position, letting the arms dangle. We move into exercise number 5, which is head and neck rotations. And let the spine get involved here too. So we're going to do 3 head and neck rotations in each direction. And we begin by waiting for our exhalation. And then when that exhalation begins, we let the head and chin come forward, shoulders come forward, spine round in. And as you inhale, sweep the chin over towards the right shoulder and begin to straighten up. Take the head up towards the ceiling and sweep across to the right where the exhalation takes your chin down towards your left shoulder, your spine rolls in, and you let your head and your spine sag as your chin sweeps across your chest. The inhalation takes you up again towards the right shoulder, up towards the ceiling on the right, sweeping across the ceiling to the left, and exhaling the left chin down towards the left shoulder, sweeping across the midline, the belly, inhaling and letting the spine and the shoulder blades be involved in this movement as much or as little as you can. It's really a matter of relaxation to sort of just let your body follow these movements. Once you reach the midline, reverse the direction as we said, and now do 3 complete revolutions in the other direction. As you inhale, chin comes up towards the left shoulder, the left ceiling, sweeps across to the right. The exhalation takes you down towards your right shoulder. Your spine rolls in and sweeps across the midline. As you go up to the left, you're inhaling. Always inhaling as your spine lengthens and opens up. And exhaling is causing your body to roll shape as you explore the head and the neck movements and your shoulders and your spine.
And these complete head and neck rotations, exercise number 5 for the joints and
glands series, the head and neck portion. Once you come to your midline and you're all rolled in like a ball, your arms are hanging. The face is very relaxed. You can feel your eyeballs relaxed, your lips, your cheek muscles. The forehead is relaxed, the back of the neck is relaxed. You're breathing normally. Place your hands on your knees. And with an inhalation, when the inhalation comes naturally, just lift up slowly back to your starting position, sitting tall. And again, this is Stula Sharira Prajna practices, or gross body practices, as in the physical body practices. So head and neck are so important because there are so many sensory neurons in that part of your body. So speaking of awareness, you can really be very aware of those areas because you have so many sensory neurons there. So now we do our joints and glands, lion pose, simhasana. So you extend your palms, place them on your knees, spread your fingers, feel the soles of the feet on the floor, spread your toes, really energetically connect those 4 points, your 2 hands against your knees and the soles of your feet. Draw your heart through so you're really sitting tall and open your face, your mouth, stick out your tongue, open your eyes wide. And then you relax and you come up. So I just went right into this pose because many of you have practiced this before and you know that eventually we do that, what I just did, which is this rapid exhalation. So I want you just for a moment to relax your hands and your feet and say the word ha, like this, ha, 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 and then relax. So put your right hand on your belly here, navel region, and say that again, ha, 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 ha. Yeah, so you really feel that the movement is coming here. For a moment, put your hand here on your chest and watch that there is no movement here. So say it again, ha, 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 ha. Good. So you notice that this area really isn't involved in